How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We have got a great workout in store for you today with a WWE superstar who's the biggest thing to come out of Australia since Hugh Jackman. I can only be talking about the strongest woman in the WWE, the powerhouse, the one, the only, Rhea Ripley. Get over here, Rhea.
G'day.
What's the story?
G'day, g'day. What's going on?
G'day.
Terrible Aussie accent, terrible Aussie
You're
accent.
Good.
How are you doing?
Good, man, you?
Doing great.
Good.
First of all, thanks for being on Celtic Warrior Workouts.
No worries.
You've got a lot of admirers, a lot of supporters in your short time in WWE. And at the age of, the young age of what?
26.
26?
Yeah.
26 years old.
I can't believe I'm 26 already, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I won't go into my age if that's the case.
Were you always a wrestling fan?
Yeah, I loved it. Actually, I watched you growing up.
Watched me growing up?
Yeah.
That's great. We had someone else on here who watched me growing up, Austin Theory, a while back. That's crazy. But what age were we? How did you get into wrestling? How did you have that passion for WWE? Was it WWE you watched predominantly, or was there other promotions too?
So WWE was the main one that I started watching. It was just hard to watch in Australia though. Like, you had to have Foxtel, and because it was always on the weekends, and that's when I would play sports.
Okay.
But the first thing that I saw was Triple H versus Ric Flair, and Triple H shoved the screwdriver in Ric Flair's head, and I was like, yo, that's sick. I was like, I need to do this. I need to watch this. This is amazing. So I was also a brutal little kid.
When you start getting into a gym and like moving on from cardio fitness into like lifting weights, so when did that happen?
After I started wrestling.
Okay.
Yeah, so I think I was like a year, not even a year, but maybe 6 months into wrestling. And my coaches, they were like huge into lifting. We had a gym at our wrestling facility.
Right.
So like we'd always go there early and we'd lift weights, and I ended up joining in on some of their sessions, and they just absolutely killed me. They were like, we know you're strong. Yeah. We know that you can get really, really strong. So we're gonna push you to the absolute max. And that's what they did. And man, I was always like one of the only girls at the gym, and I'd work out with them and I'd try and keep up. Obviously I was like a 16-year-old girl, and they're like in their early 30s. So I'm like trying to catch up and trying to keep up. But yeah, that's when it really started. I just fell in love with it.
So it's arm day today we're gonna do, which is great, it's refreshing. Austin Theory did our all day arm workout, right? So we're gonna have to, I know you guys have a bit of a rivalry going on, you're friends, but you also have this kind of rivalry going on. So we're gonna try and blow Austin Theory's arm workout out of the water, right?
Oh, I can try.
So what are we gonna call this, Rhea?
I think that the suitable name for it would be the Nightmare Arm Workout.
The Nightmare Arm Workout by Rhea Ripley. The original WWE Nightmare. All right, here we go. You ready?
Yeah. Are you ready?
Let's go. Am I ready? No, never. I'm never ready. I'm just along for the ride. This is your journey. You talk about times where you're like, sometimes you feel intimidated and stuff. But this is the whole thing about this channel. It's like, it's all about being out of your comfort zone. It's all about learning new things. It's all about watching Drew McIntyre stretch over there like Swan Lake on his nice pink
yoga mat.
Yoga mat, yeah. Anyway,
Welcome to the ratings.
Anyway, enough going. It's Rhea Ripley's Nightmare Arm Workout. Let's go do a bit. So we're here at Winks Iron Lot, Peoria, Illinois. Before you start your first set, Rhea, do you want to like to do maybe two reps of each to show everybody at home what we're doing on this set?
Sure. What we're going to do for the bicep curl is we're not going to move the top part of our arm. We're just going to bend and squeeze. And you want to squeeze in your bicep here. And this is pretty much what it looks like. Boom.
Wow.
Boom. We will do 15 reps of the tricep pushdown. Once again, not moving the top of our arm, just bending, keeping our core activated.
Not swinging it.
Yes. You don't want to use your body. You want to use your tricep. So we'll do 15 of them into 15 overhead extensions. Boom, boom.
You're going to do the first set. I'll do the second. I'll do my first set, and then we'll just
Lash
this out. Go crazy.
Easy. And you want to go
crazy here in Peoria, Illinois.
We're going to go up as well.
Huh?
So 15 reps, we'll do whatever weight for that, and then when we go to 12, we go up in weight, and then up in weight for the 10 as well.
Sweet, okay. So a drop set then?
Sort of.
It's a drop set.
Yeah, right. Drop set, sort of.
You're spending way too much time with Matt Riddle.
Bro, I had to ride with him today.
I know, that's probably what it is. I'm joking.
So I'm going to start with 15s for 15.
Okay.
You don't want to drop the weights down either. You want to be controlled. Twelve, 13, 14, 15. Keeping everything tight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we're pretty much just warming up the muscles because we don't want to just start really, really heavy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Boom. All right.
That's one set. Very tidy. So you can put your foot on the back of the machine as well if you can't stay stable. It just makes it a little bit easier. Just a little cheat code.
You said I'm not stable.
You look stable.
Everyone says that. Hurry.
Tell
us. Let's get cracking. Twelve, right?
15.
15 on this one too?
Yep.
Okay. God, my arms are already getting pumped.
Yeah, mine hurt already.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you put any weight on that?
Huh?
Did you drop it?
No, I keep it the same as what I did. Okay. This weight will stay the same because we're doing sets of 15, but
okay.
This one will change. Now,
you went up on weight?
Yeah, now go up in weight and do set of 12.
12 reps, okay.
Yes.
So your pyramid goes, that's good.
Huh?
So the weight goes up and the reps go down.
Yes.
Okay.
For biceps only. They stay
and
the same.
Can I do the single if I want, right? Can I do the single if I want?
I mean, if you want to give up, yeah.
I'm not giving up, I'm just saying if you want to hurry.
No rest for the wicked, mate.
It's your workout.
No rest for the wicked.
You're the boss. Feel it already.
Getting warm?
Yeah.
Yeah, my arms are pumped already. Getting hard already, and we have just started.
How many reps on this one, Rhea?
12 again.
12 again, okay. Yep. Same weight, right, as the last one?
Yep.
Okay.
It's getting warm in here.
Yep. I'm telling you.
It's getting hard, isn't it?
Many reps in this, Rhea?
So this one's the last one. It's 10 reps.
10, okay.
Go up again.
All right, so I'm gonna go up to 35s.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I do. 35s, here we go.
35s for 10 reps.
Come on.
Sounds like it sucks.
I'm getting pressed up now, man. Everybody be like, oh, man, Sheamus is curling 35s. Wow. More than likely, be like, is that all? It doesn't matter. You leave your ego at the door.
Exactly.
What do we do, Rhea, when we're finished with our weights?
Wait, we put them away.
Re-rack.
Re-rack them.
Jack.
Gym etiquette.
Sounds like an Aussie thing, right? Re-rack.
Re-rack. Jack. Re-rack, Jack.
See that? I'm doing the best Aussie accent ever. Come on.
Re-rack, Jack.
Yeah! Look at that.
This is the last set of this one. Thank goodness. Nearly there.
I'm trying not to grunt as much anymore. I watched back the Ricochet Imam workout.
Oh yeah?
And it just sounded like I was making sex noises the whole time. I was like, oh my god.
Oh no.
I was like, ugh, I think I'll rewatch that one on mute. I was like, ugh.
You're a gym grunter.
I know, I am, right?
Bloody
hell.
For the
longest time I wasn't, and then it just happened one day. I think it was something in the gym, I was listening to him or something, and then he just got out of control. Get out of control!
That's what happens at the gym.
Out of control. What is the most annoying noise you hear in the gym? Go on, do it.
Grunting, there was one. Oh my god, there was one.
Right.
I couldn't help but stare at him because he was just making so much noise, but he was lifting and he was like, and I was like, bro, calm down, like, it's not that heavy.
What weight was on the bar?
Not much. I can't tell what it is because it's like different weights to me, but like, I knew that I could lift it.
Kilos and pounds? Do that one again, just show. We're good. No. The method acting here from Rhea Ripley. Take one.
Is that whistling a little bit? It's hard to do.
I can't even do it by trying. No, all right, what's next?
Some of the noises that come out of people. So, next is two different tricep exercises with another bicep.
Okay.
We are gonna do easy bar scullies on the bench.
Scullies, okay.
Yep.
Sounds like something from Dublin, scullies.
Scullies,
I'm sorry.
No, you're good.
I feel like if we're doing scullies, we're a bit close there.
Yeah, probably a little bit.
Pull it out a bit.
So we're gonna do 15 scullies.
The molders and scullies.
Scullies.
What was that called again? What was that thing called? X-Files. The molders and scullies.
So, oh my god.
So the molders, the scullies, and the molders, right?
Yep.
X-Files, sorry.
Yep. So we'll do 15 scullies.
I don't even know what X-Files is.
No, I mean, I've heard of it before, but I can't remember what it is.
Okay,
but yeah, 15 scullies into 15 close tricep press.
Molders.
Molders. Yep. And then we're going to go over to the cables, and we're going to do the rope, and we're going to do some bicep curls, some hammer ones. Done.
Great form, Rhea.
Thanks, man. You want to get a nice pinch at the top. Your core activated the whole time.
This is a bit light for me, but it's all right.
It is a bit light. We'll put some more weight on it.
I'll get the tens next.
Very nice. The way that I challenge myself with this one is I try to gently, very gently, boop myself on the head with the bar, because then I know that I'm going low enough.
Yeah.
So make sure we're touching. Good.
Okay. All right, it's all you, sis. Show me these arms are bigger than theories right here. Come on.
Yeah. All day.
There you wishes. Huh? Too heavy?
Little bit.
It's all right. We keep going. We do what we can, right?
We do what we can. That's why I like to adjust and just do as I feel.
Yeah.
Sort of thing.
And if you can't like do the certain amount of weights, don't worry about it. You compromise. Do what you can do. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Just do as many as you can.
Exactly.
If you don't hit the 15, you don't hit the 15. Try and get 12. And then when you can't do 12, try and do 10. Can't do that, do 8.
Yeah. And so forth and so forth.
Exactly.
She's stalling. Go.
A little bit. I'm getting tired. That's okay. Because we persevere and we keep going. I always feel it in my chest a little bit too, because I try and push them together. So it's like a double sort of workout.
Yeah.
Burns them out though.
Yep, totally. Big difference. Killing it, man. Killing it. All right, quick one as well.
Yeah.
What's your favorite cheat meal?
Pizza.
Any type?
See, I love just cheese. Cheesy cheese.
So cheese pizza.
Yeah.
Cheese on it.
The cheesiest.
And more cheese. Is there any particular type of cheese? Mozzarella?
All of it.
Brie?
All of it. Provolone?
Provolone.
Love provolone.
Cheddar.
With mozzarella. Yeah. Bit of everything. But if I'm feeling spicy, Hawaiian with pineapple for all you pineapple haters. Are you one of them?
I love pineapple pizza.
Do you?
Yeah.
Good.
Because I'm weird.
We can get along now.
I'm like Wade Barrett, I'm weird. Ow, I just dropped my toe.
Okay. There we go. Get it.
I'm definitely sweating now.
They're getting very hard. Very, very difficult. Ooh. That's burning. Very nice. Very nice. Very tidy.
Well, thank you very much.
No worries.
Behave. I sent you a carry-on joke. Did you have that last Friday?
Huh?
Carry-on movies.
Carry-on what? Bro, I haven't been in Australia for a long time.
I know. It's
been a while. So we're gonna do reverse tricep pull down.
Okay.
And then reverse bicep curl.
Okay.
Keep these bits still.
Yeah.
Tense, keep your ab activated.
Your core. Exactly. Okay.
Core activated.
What if you don't have any abs?
I mean, I'm preaching to the choir right here.
You do, but I
know. No, I know. It's like the one thing I'm lacking, that and legs.
Abs are overrated. Abs are overrated.
Screw up.
Everyone who doesn't have abs.
Yeah. Boom. You want to try and keep your wrists straight as well, because it might hurt. Same with this one. Just bend up. Keep your wrists straight. Keep your core tight.
My turn. You don't even need much weight on this at all.
No. The reverse are good because you don't need much weight, so you can't bring your ego into it, because
yeah.
You're going to feel it no matter what. It's just a different sort of pull.
Yeah, you can't cheat these.
Yeah. This one gets very, very difficult after a while. Gets to a part where you can't really pull it up any higher. It just sort of stops at a certain point.
Yeah, it's pretty much isolation exercise. So
yes.
You can't swing it, you can't do it. It really is strict.
Yeah.
And you can feel it right away.
Concentrated.
All right, boss, I'll follow you.
Let's
go for it.
Let's do it. You can have your feet together, a little bit apart, or as I like to do, sometimes I go like, one toe and one flat foot because I'm weird.
That's very, like aerobics.
Yeah. I don't know why, but my body just sort of does it naturally. So I sort of just stick with it sometimes.
Watch those Jane Fonda videos back in the day, were you? Jane Fonda videos.
Maybe.
With your football boots.
My sprigs. Woo! since it's the next round, we're going up and we're doing 12. Why? Because I don't want to feel my arms before I have to wrestle.
Go. 12 reps. This is third round, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Just wait till we get to the finisher. He doesn't want to bend anymore. That's your last thing at 12, and then we're going 10. Ow. My body doesn't want to curl no more. My arms don't want to curl.
Like the gusset.
Yeah. This is a great stretch, by the way. Great stretch for your back. You got it. There we go. There we go. Nearly that. There we go. Go to your fail. We are going to do hammer curls. We're going to do body weight dips.
Okay.
And we're going to do preacher curl on the cable machine.
All right. So our arms are on the ropes. Yes. And now we're going to lead one to them and knock them out all together.
Yep. Great. We're going to do 3 sets of 30 on everything.
So that's 90 of everything.
Yes.
So 3 sets of 30. Okay. All right. All right, Rhea. What time is it?
Last set, best set.
Let's do it. Come on.
It's going to get very hard. Oh my God. So try and put your arms on your knees. Yeah. I'm gonna have to drop it because this is too heavy for 30. I'm not as strong as Sheamus.
You dropped it?
Yeah.
What do you got left?
We got 2 more rounds, bro.
No, those reps.
Oh, that's it. You can go singles if you need. It's getting difficult. Mouth. Arms are jelly.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, you're careful, my arms, man.
30 is a lot.
Jesus.
Hey.
I'll drop on my for next one.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to drop again too.
Yeah. Okay, come on, come on, Rhea.
This one sucks.
Let's go.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, that sucks.
Jeez, man, I can't feel
my everything hurts.
Here we go.
I feel my arms. You good? You good? You got it, you got it. You got it. You got it. You got it. There we go. That was the last one for that, so we're just gonna do this one. Bro, my arms are so pumped. I'm so scared.
I can't feel my arms. All right. Okay. Here we go. Oh my God. For people at home, for fans who look up to you, for fans, for people who've stumbled across this episode, who've never worked out, for people who have worked out, is there a message you want to give them?
Stay determined. Doesn't matter how many people doubt you in your life. They're just doubters at the end of the day. They won't accomplish anything because they're too busy looking at you in your life, where you can just prove them wrong and work and hustle and just believe in yourself. Don't give up. I know it's as generic as it sounds, but if you put your mind to it and your body into it, you could do anything that you want. I mean, look at me, little girl from Adelaide, South Australia, over here in America wrestling for the WWE. If you stay dedicated and focused, you can do anything that your little heart desires.
Absolutely, 100% right. Couldn't agree with you more. Chris Hemsworth, AC/DC, Bleeding Crocodile Dundee, nothing. I'm this WWE superstar here right here. Rhea, thank you so much for being on the channel. Thank you for not just inspiring me, but inspiring everybody at home. And remember, you too, by doing this workout, can no longer feel any part of your arms.
Yes, completely dead.
So from me,
from
Big Rhea here, giant, gigantic Jack Rhea Ripley, always remember that first step is the most important step.
Yes.
To a brave change.
Exactly.
All right, how am I gonna get out of here now? Just roll, let's roll.
Yeah.
Roll. This is good, but how are we gonna open the door?
I don't know. I don't really know.
This is your fault, by the way. This is all your fault.